In this video, we're actually going to take a look at deploying Azure SQL Database using the Azure portal. So here I am in the Azure portal, and what you can see is from the Home tab, I've simply searched for Azure SQL. Now, what this is going to allow me to do is see that unified experience we talked about earlier. Since we're going to create a database in this demo, I'm just going to go ahead and select Create. Now, what I'm going to see next is this basics blade. And if you recall from the videos, we actually walked through what these different blades are. So now we're actually going to walk through them, except filling them in. So I'm going to select my resource group, and then I'm going to give this database a name. We're going to use the AdventureWorks sample. So I'm just going to go ahead and title it AdventureWorks plus a unique character or string of numbers. The next thing I'm going to do is create a server. And here in the server name, I'm just going to call it the AdventureWorks server, followed by that unique number. This server name has to be globally unique, which is why you saw the check mark there. Next, I'm going to give a server admin login. And you can see there are some specifics about things I can and can't do. Then I'm going to supply a password, making sure I meet the password requirements, and also making sure I remember that password. Finally, I'm going to select a location or region for the server to be deployed, and I'm going to select East US. Now, once it's there, I can do things like opt in for elastic pools, which I'm not going to do in this case, and I can also select the compute and storage. When I click this, I'm going to have quite a few different options. If I click over here looking for basic, standard, or premium, I can see those DTU options that are available in Azure SQL Database. Upon the top, I also see our various service tiers, general purpose, hyperscale, and business critical. For today, I'm going to start with a general purpose database using provisioned compute, but I could alternatively select serverless here if that's what I wanted to use. Now I can see I'm just going to go ahead and use the default hardware selection, which is Gen 5. And I have some options here around Azure Hybrid Benefit, and as well as options on scaling the number of cores and my data max size. This is going to be a pretty small database, so I'm just going to leave it like this and hit apply. Next, I'm going to go into the networking tab, and this is where I select how I want people to connect to this. We'll talk more in depth about this in the security module. For now, the easiest thing is to just use the public endpoint and allow Azure services and resources access to the server, and even adding my current client IP address. So this is going to make sure that the machine, or in this case, the virtual machine that I'm deploying Azure SQL Database on, is going to have access to that Azure SQL Database logical server. Now, in additional settings, you'll see I have options for a backup or a sample database. I'm going to use the sample, and the sample is AdventureWorks LT. Notice that I cannot select the database collation here, and the reason for that in this specific case is that it's already defined by this sample. I also have an option for advanced data security, and I'm going to go ahead and start that free trial. Finally, I have tags, which I think I mentioned that I can do something like select an environment and refer to this as my development environment. This is going to help me group things when it comes to billing and subscription management. In Review and Create, I can review all the options that have been selected and go ahead and select Create. Now, this is going to initialize and start kick off a deployment, and this will take about 2 to 3 minutes. Now, once the deployment is complete, I can look at some of the deployment details, like what was deployed and the status of it, or any details if something goes wrong. I can also download this. Since everything went well, I'm going to go ahead and go to the resource. Now, once I'm in the resource, I'm seeing a lot of things, which we'll learn more about as we go throughout. The main thing I want to grab here is the server name. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. And that's how we're going to actually connect to this database server in SSMS. If I switch over to SSMS, I wanted to give a brief reminder of how you might connect using other SQL Server deployment options. For example, on this virtual machine that you see, I have SQL Server 2019 deployed. So you might be familiar with Windows authentication, and I can just deploy to the local instance by using dot. So I'm going to go ahead and connect, And under databases, you'll see I also have the AdventureWorks database deploy. Now let's take a look at connecting to a managed instance. I have one stored here, so I'm just going to go ahead and connect to that. Notice I'm using SQL Server auth, and go ahead and connect. And now right off the bat, what you can tell is there's a little bit of a difference in these little icons. And in the databases for managed instance, what I'm going to see is I'm going to be able to see all these system databases. And if I expand that for SQL Server, I'm going to see something similar here as well. Now, the final option I wanted to show you is connecting to that database server we just deployed. So I'm going to go ahead and paste that in here, that awserver0602.database.windows.net. And I'm going to supply my password. And there are a few options I have here. I can choose to actually connect to a specific database. As you'll see in later modules, sometimes you might only have access to a specific database as opposed to the whole logical server. So I might want to specify that here. For now, I'll just connect to the whole logical server. And I'm going to go ahead and select connect. Now, what we're going to see here is a little bit different. So if I go into system databases, notice that I'm only seeing master, whereas in managed instance and in SQL Server, I have some other options. And again, this just comes with the fact that you're not really getting access to a whole SQL Server. A lot of that is being abstracted away from you. So you just really get a database. So that's what I see here. And I can even run, you know, the classic query, which is select at version. And you can see that when I run this, I'm connected to Microsoft SQL Azure. So in this video, you saw how simple it can be to deploy Azure SQL Database. We encourage you to check out the actual lab in our GitHub and Microsoft Learn to try it for yourself. Thanks for tuning in.